Psalm 118, verse 24, reads as follows. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Can one be happy and sad at the same time? Ambivalence means feeling both good and bad. We are partly sad in solidarity with our colleagues who are not able to graduate with us this morning. Although we have always wished to close off this chapter together as we have started it. However, the Lord's plans are not always our plans. We are happy today, equally sad, because many who encouraged us to be here are no longer with us. Some who fought for us to be here are no longer with us. Many who were happy that we eventually decided to take this path are also no longer with us. May we rejoice on this day in honor of our departed parents and loved ones who cannot witness this day with us. May I humbly request the audience to rise and observe a moment of silence for our loved ones. Thank you. Revered Reverends, doctors in various fields of specialization, bishops in absentia of the various churches represented here, the rector of Paulinium, my fellow graduates, our P0s, students of the ULTS Paulinium Seminary, beloved audience present here this morning, thank you for the opportunity awarded to me. To speak on behalf of the graduates and of my fellow classmates. For many of us, it was like yesterday when we started our studies. For myself specifically, I was very much excited to attend the university on a full-time basis and live at school with fellow students, because I have only attempted on a distance basis, part-time basis. So that was the greatest excitement for me. Many of us had no clue what to expect. All we knew is that God has made it happen for us. In fact, this was not only applicable to me, but to the majority of us, as we all landed at Paulinium in our own unique and miraculous ways. Some quit their jobs in order to heed to the call of God. Others knew exactly since they were growing up that they wanted to become pastors. Some had dreams and visions. I remember the day exactly in this chapel when Reverend Dr. Shebeba was asking us why we wanted to become pastors. And each and every one of us had our own reasons. And today, I realize that perhaps it was deliberately done so that we don't lie while answering this very important question while in the house of God. I believe that our class was and still is one of a kind. Many buckets stopped and started with us. And especially the bucket of our fellow students not graduating with us today. Yes, we do understand that as an institution, it has to be run on business terms as well, and we have accepted it as such. We are one of a kind because of our uniqueness in character, mannerisms, and I always hear one of my classmates echoing over and over saying, guys, we have to learn to accept one another the way we are. Some of us did not know what to expect here at Paulino and only got here with one mission, and that is to go serve God upon completion of our studies. We wondered why we were learning Hebrew, Greek, African, especially African traditional religion. Where does it fit? When we should simply be concentrating on studying the Bible in detail. I remember someone mentioning that they thought we would just be reading the Bible over and over and over again. My fellow classmate even broke the record of Moses spending 40 nights and 40 days on the mountain. This morning he admitted that he just came back from the mountain. And last time, we understood that he spent 60 days and 60 nights on the mountain. That is our very own Moses. And the one day, Moses came back to school with bruises on the arms and on the knees. Moses, where are you coming from? I'm coming from the mountain. Moses. Moses. We have the Kupferberg Mountains very far there in the range. And I remember many years ago we would go hiking on those mountains. So Moses said he wanted to go see something on that mountain. Well, he also went to pray, and he prayed for all of us, I am sure. Moses is really one of a kind. I'm sorry that I have to single him out. Some of us even dared to claim the title of King Solomon. I myself am really not one who would hear most stories of what is happening on the campus, because I am very undiplomatic and I would always talk casually about stuff that I have witnessed or heard without realizing the secrecy of these things. I was very much banned. One of my brothers was baptized to the kingdom of Windhoek while he was in the bushes with his seniors chilling. Now, who dares to go chill with the seniors? Ne? He was very, very privileged to chill with the seniors. But the kingdom of Windhoek got hold of them. He left his seniors there in the bushes with the vehicle and he ran up to Paulinum, if I remember correctly. That is the kingdom of Windhoek. We have together survived the darkest nights of illnesses. Some survived cancer. This is not just a speech. It is the truth. Some of us survived spinal TB. If you know what spinal TB does to you, it paralyzes you. We survived spinal TB without paralyzation. And I believe that is simply because of the Spirit of God that is in us. Our Reverend Doctor mentioned that a theologian who does not pray is not a theologian. We prayed. We stayed up nights and morning, not only praying for ourselves, but also praying for our fellow students. We have survived depression. We survived heavy migraines, which would only visit colleagues when it is mostly examination time. Some of us survived what we have not heard of, but still they survived thanks to our good and faithful God and his devoted sons and daughters who spent sleepless nights with us.